Tributes pouring in for the first man to ever run a mile in under 4 minutes. Roger Bannister passed away at his home Saturday at the age of 88. He became the first person to break the four-minute mile when he clocked in at 3 minutes, 59.4 seconds in 1954. British Prime Minister Theresa May tweeted her condolences, saying Bannister was a sporting icon and inspiration to us all. Well, Don Riddell of World Sport has more on this. And there is no doubt you and I growing up will remember his name on a regular basis. Mm. He had a huge impact, not just on his own sport, but on sport as a whole, didn't he?
Absolutely. I mean, what he achieved in 1954 really was a landmark feat, an iconic moment in sport. It propelled him into conversations where he was compared with the likes of Jesse Owens, Babe Ruth, and, you know, some of the real icons of the history of sport. It was an extraordinary moment. You have to remember the time. This was an amateur era for track and field. This sub 4 minute mile wasn't even the main focus of his day. He was a medical student. He actually began his day doing his rounds on the wards before he took the train to Oxford to try and break what at this point was considered really a mystical barrier. There were some people who didn't even think it was possible. Running wasn't even his main focus. It was kind of something he did really in his spare time, but he was still very, very passionate about it, obviously. And he kind of brought us a more scientific approach to this race because he did think that it would be possible to break the four-minute mile. It has to be said that his moment, his record, barely lasted a month. It was broken, I think, 46 days later. But nobody remembers who broke it next. Everybody remembers what he did. And as you say, Becky, when you and I were kids, I mean, he was a household name in the United Kingdom. He inspired a whole raft of other athletes, such as the current president of World Athletics, Sebastian Coe, who said there is not a single athlete of his generation who was not inspired by what Roger Bannister did.
What did he do afterwards, Don?
Well, that's very interesting. And he's actually equally well known for what he did away from the track. He retired the same year. He retired in 1954 to focus on his medical studies. And he spent the next four decades being one of the leading neurologists in his field. And he has since said that actually that for him is a much more important achievement than what he did on the track in Oxford. But he was absolutely revered. He was quite a private man. He was very, very humble. Unfortunately, he passed away at the age of 88, having acquired Parkinson's disease back in 2011. And he did comment about that. He said, you know, having studied so many other brains in his professional life, that he found there was a gentle irony to the fact that it was Parkinson's that he acquired. But he will be very, very missed by the world of athletics and the world of sport, and his name will forever endure.
Remarkable, sort of those the innocent days of amateur athletics. When you break a record like that, it seems so many moons ago, doesn't it? What an extraordinary man.